Hey guys, so I am here with a Try the World box, and I'm super excited because I haven't had one of these in a while. If you're not familiar with Try the World, they do come out every other month, so that's why it's been a while. They are $39 a month, and they are themed for one specific country. So I have tried so many countries. I've tried Morocco, Brazil, Thailand, there's been a few boxes. I can't remember them all. France. So let's see what this one is. They have it right here inside the cover of the box. What does it say? Sweden. Oh, so I didn't get a Sweden box. I don't know what I think. My brain. All right, so this is the culture guide. Inside the culture guide, they kind of tell you everything that's in here. I'll let you go ahead and have a peek. I don't honestly want to have a peek, so I'm not even going to look. I don't even know what's going on. But I should see who the curator of the box is. Let's see. Let's check it out. All right, the curator of the box is Chef Emma Bengston. I'm sorry if I totally butchered that up. She's from a small town on Sweden's western coast. Learn the secrets of Nordic cuisine. All right, so let's just get into the box. Let's see what this is. All right, first thing I'm gonna pull out here, it feels like coffee or tea, in this little bag here. It's ground coffee, so I'll just go ahead and bring this one to work and let's see what my coworkers think about it. So it's a 6 to 8 cups of coffee in here. Then we have, something is Nordic fudge. Fudge with a Nordic flavor of rose hip. Sweet to meet you, it says. Cane sugar syrup, cane sugar, cream, butter, rose hip powder. It's 100% organic ingredients. So it's strange. It comes in like a little bag like this. I wonder if, like, how it is inside. Let's check it out here. Oh, interesting. Oh, they're like little chunks. I just totally squeezed the bag like I'm crazy, you know? That's interesting. I totally squished the bag because I was like, oh, okay, what is this? And I'm like, squish, squish. It's fudge, but it looks like little caramels. Interesting. It smells different. I'm not familiar. I don't know that scent. I guess that's the rose hip. I'm scared to try it. Let's see. Oh. It's buttery, it's a little tangy and sour, and that is really, really unique and really good. It says here, oh my God, that is so good. It has like a little lemony something to the background. It kind of gives you that little zing in your cheeks. It's really delicious. The serving size, one package. So this whole package is one serving. That's a whole heck of a lot of fudge. It says it's only 270 calories for this whole thing. I would have imagined it would have been way more because it's very sweet, but I don't know. It's definitely creamy. It's not gooey. It doesn't melt like chocolate. It's a little bit gritty, but not too gritty. It's very unique and it's delicious. Nordic fudge. Guys, go find that. Try it. I'm not kidding. Seriously. Google it. You gotta try it. Delicious. Wow. The next thing is sweet licorice. Fun fact about Annette. Annette don't like licorice. And it's black licorice, I'm assuming. Oh gosh, no. Oh, I can't eat it. I'm sorry. If there's anything that... I'm going to open it for you so you can see what it is. But Annette don't like licorice. I have to say that it doesn't kind of... Like I picture like those Twizzlers kind of black licorice. Oh, I don't like it. That's that almost like that star anise kind of scent. I'm just like... I'll take like a little Eevee. It Some people love licorice. I just don't. I don't like the texture. I don't like the flavor. I'm not a fan. So for those of you who do like licorice, and especially black licorice, maybe you would like it. But for me, I'm just not a fan of licorice. I left the little bit that I took out right here. But I don't even like the scent. Don't. Oh, cool. Lingonberry. This is something that I got, not this particular, but the berry itself. I'm familiar with the name because I did get in a snack box, which I do actually have right here. They have lingonberries in here, and they're delicious. I don't know which one is the lingonberry. It's red, obviously, because this jam is red. But traditional Swedish preserve lingonberry. It smells kind of like it's going to be like a sour kind of jam. Let's try. I'm going to try it from the little lid here. There's a little bit on the lid. It's kind of sweet and kind of tangy. It kind of reminds me of like when you would get those snow cones from like the little truck that comes by and they put the red juice on top of the snow cone. That is the flavor that it reminds me of. It's like that red that you're not sure what flavor that is. That maybe it's supposed to be strawberry, but maybe it's supposed to be cherry, but you're not sure. It's that. So that's interesting. Very interesting. Okay, the next thing we have here, Swedish gourmet crisps. So I don't know if this box, it looks like maybe this box is just one variety. Interesting. They have different types of crisps. You can see on the box, they have like prosciutto. That would be really yummy, I bet. And then just like some plain ones. So I'm really interested in, I would love to have tried all of these actually. So they're flatbread original, flatbread crisps in the original flavor. So let's check it out. They kind of look like they're soaked in butter or something like that. And then, or like they're deep fried or something. I wonder how they're made. They're really crispy, really like hard, like a pita chip. So it says that for thousands of years, women baked flatbread made of barley, the only grain that grew in Sweden. To revive stale bread, they brushed it with oil and baked it again. Ah, that makes sense. It almost tastes buttery in your mouth. Like as it's going down and like the aftertaste in your mouth, it's really, really good. It's not too salty. It's almost like it's a dried out bread, just like they said. It's really good. It's, I don't know. It kind of reminds me of pita crisps, but like the thick, thick ones. But better. All right, next we have sweet and hot honey mustard. Ooh, interesting. From Les Ellis, gold medal winner. Okay, it says, this incredible mustard has won over 16 awards in worldwide competitions over the past 7 years. Their secret is using domestically grown mustard seeds and combining them with local honey and high quality spices. So it's not full all the way to the top. It's like you get the bottle has like this much mustard in there. Oh, it's very strong. It's got mustard seeds in there, and I'm not a big fan of mustard. I do like to cook with it. Like if you put it all over a pork loin and put it in the oven, it's delicious that way. You guys should try it. Oh, wow. It's very thick and kind of, it's interesting. Oh, that is so weird. That is so weird. I mean, again, I'm not a big fan of mustard, and this is honey mustard, and it's kind of, I don't know, I guess that's what honey mustard tastes like, but it's like a gritty honey mustard. I don't know. I don't know. I'm not a huge fan of this honey mustard, but you know, I'm willing to give it a go. When you put it in the oven, you cook with it, it changes the flavor dramatically. So I'm definitely going to try it out with cooking And, you know, if anybody else is interested in trying this in the household, they can, you know, they're more than welcome to it. Next is, I don't know how to say it, it's an elderflower syrup. Oh, interesting. I've never heard of it. Don't know what to do with it. I assume it's like pancake syrup. I don't know. So it says, Saft is a sweet and refreshing syrup that's typically mixed with water. Oh, we do not recommend drinking it on its own. This one is made from organic elderflowers grown on a farm and practices crop rotation, a farming technique that replenishes nutrients to the soil. So you mix a little bit of this in water and I guess you have a drink. You know, in IKEA, I know, I mentioned in IKEA, they have like these bottles, they look like wine bottles and soda bottles, and it's of a drink, like their own drink. I don't know if this is it, but it's like a mixture of like some kind of syrup and like a soda water, or some is just like a water or something like that. I'm gonna open it and smell it. I wonder if that is the same thing. Oh man. Oh gosh, what is that? People? I'm not sure. Oh gosh, but the smell is horrible. It doesn't taste as bad as it smells. It's interesting. I have to test it out and see what it's about. It doesn't taste as bad as it smells. It really doesn't. But I'm gonna definitely try it out and mix it in with some water and see what it does. How does it taste? I don't know. One last item. We have double chocolate chip crisps. Can't go wrong with chocolate chip. And these are crisps, so sounds interesting. So they come in a package like this. They're kind of a little tossed around. Okay, it says that these double chocolate crisps, they're used local ingredients, Southern Sweden. Gill cookies have gained incredible popularity, becoming a staple treat in many Swedish homes. They kind of smell like they have oatmeal or something. Not like chocolate chip cookies that I was expecting. They're unique. They're like a thin crisp of, I don't know, like a... very unique. These are interesting. I've tried some really neat things in this box. All right, so this is everything that came in this Sweden box. A lot of interesting things, pretty cool things. This was delicious. The coffee, I'm not sure about. I'm gonna share it with my coworkers. The drink, I can't wait to try it out to see what it's all about. And then we have the sweet honey mustard, which was weird as heck to me. This lingonberry, which was kind of tasty. It's different. I'm just not used to these types of flavors. These were yummy. The cookies were interesting and good. So cool to try different things from another part of the world that I probably would never have tried if I didn't get it out of the Try the World box. So it is $39 every other month. So if you're interested, I will have all the information down below. Go ahead and check it out. What do you guys think about these different types of things? Have you tried any of them? Do you like them? Do you not like them? Let me know in the comments section. And that's all I got for you. Go ahead and be on the lookout for the snack box that is coming up. It's either up already or it's coming up. I'm not sure which one's going to be coming out first. I do have a coupon code for you guys. You can use A1Netty to get 15% off of your box or something in their shop. If somebody signs up for the box, I do get I think it's like a $15 towards their shop that I can use the money on. All right, you guys, I hope you enjoyed that. Again, leave me whatever you want to tell me down in the comment section. I will see you again in another video. Bye.